Hello everyone, this is Asim. Welcome to Abroad Knowledge Channel. First of all, I would like to thanks for supporting us by liking and subscribing to our channel. Today I am going to tell you some important facts about human body. I cover up these topics from the very same book name called Still More Tell Me Why. Okay, let's start the topic. First is, what is a stroke? A stroke is a form of injury to the brain. Another name for it is apoplexy. Let's see how does it happen. When a stroke occurs, the flow of blood to a part of the brain is suddenly cut off. As a result, all the structures connected with that part are injured. There are several things that can cause this failure of the blood to reach part of the brain. A blood vessel may be ruptured and cause a hemorrhage. A clot may form within the blood vessel. This is called thrombosis. There may be spasm of an artery, or a blood vessel may become closed off because of a small particle. Often a blood clot floating in the bloodstream, this is called an embolus. So what is embolus? An embolus is usually linked up with heart disease, but it may occur in other disease too. In terms of damage, it does not matter what causes of the stroke. The part of the brain through which pass the nerves that control our voluntary motions, our sensations of pain, our temperature, touch, and vision may be damaged. The most frequent cause of stroke is thrombosis. Strangely enough, a person can have this kind of stroke after a period of inactivity. For example, a person might wake up in the morning to discover that an arm or a leg or even a whole side of the body is useless. Or he may find that he can hardly speak or speak not at all. People with this kind of stroke have a pretty good chance of recovery, but there is usually some permanent disability. In treating a stroke, the doctor has to find out what caused it. So he needs a complete history of the illness of the person. People who become crippled in some way by a stroke can often be rehabilitated, that is, trained to regain the use of the function that was crippled. This includes use of muscles and the ability to speak again. Here we can see the picture of brain stroke. Let's go to the next topic. Why do we have a skeleton? So what is skeleton? There are two main jobs that skeleton does. It supports the body and it protects delicate organs. Okay? The skeleton is the frame that holds man erect. It is made mostly of bones. A baby is born with as many as 270 small, rather soft bones in his framework. A fully grown person usually has 206 bones. Some bones become fused or grow together. Bones fit together at joints and are held fast by ligaments, which are like through cords, like tough cords or straps. Some joints can be moved freely. For example, when you run, you move your legs at the hip and knee joints. When you throw a ball, you move your arm at the shoulder and the elbow joints. Here you can see the picture. When you run, you see your legs are moving at the hip and knee joints. With use of hip and knee joints, your legs are moving. When you throw a ball, in the next picture, you see that when you throw a ball, you move your arm at the shoulder and elbow joints. Okay? Some joints cannot be moved at all at the base of spine in the bones are fused, forming one bony plate that fits into another. Neither move the joint in your skull or solid tongue except for those in the jaw. It is hard for us to think of bone as living tissue, but it is. It grows when a person is young. For example, the thigh bone may triple in length between the time a person is born and the time he is fully grown. Okay? Bones grow in length and thickness as calcium and other minerals are added to them. And since bones is living tissue, it must be fed. The outside of the bone is covered with a thin, tough skin. The skin holds many tiny blood vessels that carry pawn to the bone cells. The middle of a bone is spongy and filled with marrow. Some of the marrow is a storehouse for fat, and other makes red blood cells. Here you can see the pictures of a skeleton of our body. What we can see is spinal column, skull and rib cage, spongy matter, marrow, cross skeleton of bones. These are the types of the bones human body consists of. The total number of bones is 206. The middle of the bone is spongy and filled with marrow. Here you can see the spongy matter. This is spongy matter. That is a spongy. The middle bone is spongy and filled with marrow. Some of the marrow is a storehouse for a fat. Okay? Let's go to the next topic. Next one is, why is one of our feet bigger than the other? Have you ever noticed this? You probably noticed that when you buy shoes and the man measures your feet, one foot is larger than the other. Since one foot doesn't do any more work than the other, why should this be so? Let's get to know about this. It is related to the fact that our body is asymmetrical, that is, it does not consist of two identical halves, right and left. You can see this for yourself in many ways. If you look at your face in the mirror, you will notice that the right half of your face is more developed than the left. The right cheek is more prominent and the mouth, eyes and ear are molded with greater precision. The same applies to the rest of our body. The legs are not equal in strength and dexterity. The heart is on the left side and the liver on the right side. So that internally the body is not exactly balanced. The result is that our skeleton develops in a slightly unbalanced way. Okay? Now, this slight difference can have a tremendous effect on how we do things. The uneven structure of the body causes us to walk unevenly. The result is that when we cannot see, as in a snowstorm, a fog, or when blindfold, we will walk in a circle. The same is true of animals, whose body structure is also uneven. And if anyone were to drive a car blindfold, he would end up driving in a circle. When we come to the questions of the right-handed and the left-handed people, we run into something curious. 96% of all people are right-handed. But this is not due to asymmetry of the body. It is due to asymmetry of the brain. Okay? The left half of the brain controls the right side of the body and vice versa. Since the left half of the brain predominates over the right half, this makes the right half of our body more skilled and makes most of us right-handed. Okay, let's go to the next topic. The next one is, what does blood do for the body? It is very important for us. Here, blood is very necessary for the life of every part of the body. The first step in understanding this is to realize that the blood contains many different materials and cells. There is a fluid or liquid part of the body which is called plasma. It contains many substances dissolved in it. Let's see what some of these are and what they do. Okay? Carbohydrates such as sugar are in the blood to give the body energy. Fats are in the fluid for burning or storage. Many salts are also in the blood to meet the body's needs. The blood plasma carries food from the blood plasma carries food from the stomach, the intestine to the cell, which would starve without it. It also carries waste from the cells to the kidneys and intestine. The red cells in the blood, which give the blood its color, contains a substance called hemoglobin. The body has a great need for hemoglobin because it combines easily with gases such as oxygen and carbon dioxide. The red cells carry the oxygen in the arteries and capillaries to all cells of the body. And the white cells in the body called leukocytes. Okay, leukocytes are very important to the body. Why it is important? It can destroy the bacteria. And the other white cells called lymphocytes are part of the body's process for fighting infections. Still, the other white blood cell called monocytes take care of the dead materials and dirt that may get into the body. These three white cells are more important for the body. Why? Because first, leukocytes can destroy bacteria, and another one, lymphocytes, can fighting the infections in our body. Still other white blood cells called monocytes, it can take care of the dead materials and dirt that may get into the body. So these all are more important white cells of our body. In addition, the blood contains pieces of cells called platelets that help to form clots, so that when the blood vessels is cut, you do not lose too much blood. Here you can see the pictures of blood. See the picture, the blood donating blood sites, and another picture is red cells. It shows red cells, platelets, white cells. These are very important. It contains in blood. Okay. So let's go to the next topic. Is how do we read? How do we read? That means we read books, we read newspapers, we read messages, that's all, etc. So here, let's go see how do we read. When you read, you look at certain symbols and are able to get some meaning from them. For example, a kind of reading is going on when you read symbols on your road sign. When you read symbols on a road sign, you can see the road signs, just like go white and white sea and go, let's go, just like signals. These are the road signs, okay? And other, when an engineer reads the marking on a blueprint, when an Indian sees smoke signals. When we say reading, we usually mean reading, print or writing, but here too, we must understand the symbols. The first thing we have to do is learning to read. Is it recognize the symbols or letters as being different from others? Then we must get the idea for which a word or group of symbols stands. Over the years, children have been taught to read by various methods. The spelling method begins by teaching the child the names of the letters of the alphabet in order. In the phonetic method, children learn the sounds of the letters, then put the sounds together to make words. At first, only short words are made, then longer ones. In still another method, the child memorizes the way a word looks. Other methods use both sounding out and remembering the way a word face or sentence looks. But we can only learn to read when we are ready to begin learning. And for this, we must be able to see words or symbols that are alike and different. Remember the form of a word. Remember ideas in the order in which they are given. Bring to mind pictures of objects that the words describe. Move eyes from left to right on the page, and many more things. Okay, let's go to the next topic. Why do people walk in their sleep? We often hear about this, that people have a habit to walk in their sleep. There are few cases of people walking in their sleep, but while sleepwalking is a peculiar form of behavior, there is nothing mysterious about it. To understand it, let us start with deep itself. Let us start with sleep itself. We need to sleep so that our tired organs and tissues of the body will rest to be restored. We still do not have an exact scientific explanation of how and why we sleep, but it is believed that there is a sleep center in the brain which regulates the sleeping and waking of the body. What regulates this sleep center? The blood, the activity of our body all day releases certain substance into the blood. One of these is calcium. It passes into the blood and stimulates the sleep center. And the sleep center has been sanitized before by special substance so that it will react to the calcium. When the sleep center goes to work, it does two things. The first is it blocks off part of the brain so that we no longer have the will to do anything, and we no longer have consciousness. We might call this brain sleep. The second thing it does is block off certain nerves in the brain stem so that internal organs and our limbs fall asleep. Let us call this body sleep. And normally these two reactions or kind of sleep are connected. But under certain conditions they may be separated. The brain may sleep while the body is awake. The brain and the body have become disassociated and they are sleepwalkers. This might happen to a person whose nervous system does not react normally. So such people might get out of bed while their brain is asleep and walk about. Okay, finally, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Have a nice day. Thank you.